हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस प्राजक्ता कुलकर्णी, लेक्चरर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, KLS गोगटे PU कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बेलगावी. सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ऑलरेडी वी ऑल आर अवेयर दैट दिस एकेडमिक ईयर 2020 इज़ वेरी वेरी डिफ़िकल्ट फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू कैरी ऑन विथ आर लाइफ एंड डेली एक्टिविटीज इन अ स्मूथ मैनर. यू ऑल वर वेरी एक्साइटेड आई नो आफ्टर योर 10th स्टैंडर्ड एग्जाम्स दैट इन द नेक्स्ट कमिंग मंथ्स यू विल बी गोइंग टू कॉलेज एंड यू हैड मैनी फैंटसीज एज टू हाउ योर कॉलेज लाइफ वुड बी, हु वुड बी योर न्यू फ्रेंड्स, who would be your new teachers, how would be your college campus, etc. But unfortunately, till today, we are not able to meet in the college in view of the safety of our health. So, we are just able to meet in this type of recorded classes. Dear students, already two classes of English subject have been started for you. In the first and second class, the other two faculty members have started with the introduction to the syllabus, the textbook, and the introduction to English language and its usage. So, in today's class, I'm going to start with unit number 3 from your textbook. Hope you all have the text with you. If in case you do not possess one, please try to get it from the market. Which textbook, how it looks, is all explained in the very first class. I hope you remember. So let us start with unit number 3, around a medicinal creeper. So before actually we read the lesson, we always read and understand the pre-reading activity. So in our regular classes, that is in the classroom teaching, we have an interaction with you all where I ask the question which is given in the pre-reading activity and you, I mean the students, answer to it. But since this is a one-way communication class, that is, I speak and you only listen, so I shall only answer the question for you. Let's take a look at the question that is given in the pre-reading activity. The question reads, are you aware of the therapeutic value of commonly used spices like turmeric, cumin, mustard, sesame, cinnamon, cloves, garlic, ginger, pepper, etc.? So, my dear students, owing to the fast-paced world that we are living in, we are getting far from the nature. While the lifestyle that we live can have adverse effect on us, it is important to know that by introducing small changes in our daily life, we can go a long way in keeping ourselves healthy and energetic. Therefore, the importance of Ayurveda holds true in today's life, as it is based on the principle of bringing us close to nature and relying on its natural powers to cure us and keep us healthy without any side effects. We should be thankful to the use of natural ingredients and medicinal herbs. Ayurvedic medicines and products today have become a symbol of safety in contrast to synthetic drugs that are considered unsafe and hazardous for our overall health. So as we have some elements mentioned in the pre-reading activity, let us take them up one by one and try to understand their medicinal values. So here in the picture you can see the first element mentioned, that is turmeric, that is in our local language we call it haldi. This spice is packed with antioxidant, antiviral, antibacterial, antifungal, anti-carcinogenic, anti-mutagenic and anti-inflammatory properties. Turmeric's anti-inflammatory properties have been instrumental in treating osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis. So see, such medicinal values each of the elements possess. Let us read them one by one. Cumin seeds. These contain antioxidants, beneficial acids and vitamin B that balance the immune system. Black cumin seeds contains antioxidants, beneficial acids and B vitamins that balance the immune system. Moreover, they have been found superior to almost every other natural remedy when used for autoimmune disorders. Cumin seeds, as you can see in the picture, in our local language we call it Zira. Then see, mustard, mohri, yeah. This seed comes from the ground and has a spicy flavor. Native to the temperate areas of Europe, mustard helps reduce pain, stimulates appetite, and relieves symptoms of arthritis. It lowers bad cholesterol in the body, thus keeping a check on blood fat levels and helping in circulation. Sesame seeds, till, which appear in white color, off-white and black color. I hope you all have seen this. This seed has a nutty taste. It has cholesterol lowering compounds, helps balance hormones and crucially boosts nutrition absorption. Black sesame seeds are rich in vitamin B and iron, and most people who have a vitamin B or iron deficiency show symptoms like hair turning gray, hearing loss, memory loss, all of which are the indicators of aging. Cinnamon. Cinnamon is a favorite household spice which has been used throughout the world for ages. It has large number of antioxidants which protects body from body diseases and have many anti-inflammatory properties. Cinnamon forms a part of many exotic dishes and is currently trending because of its ability to reduce a tummy bloat. See, the picture you can see is of cinnamon. Dalchini, that is what we call. Then cloves, that is lavang, long. Cloves are antibacterial, antifungal and antiseptic. They are a powerhouse of antioxidants and are rich sources of minerals, omega-3 fatty acids, fiber and vitamins and minerals. Clove oil is one of the richest sources of antioxidants. So this is commonly seen in our kitchen. Garlic, lesson. It is widely used in cooking and it has been used as a medicine in ancient times because of its antimicrobial properties. Consuming garlic on a daily basis in food or in raw helps to lower cholesterol levels because of the antioxidant properties of allicin. It is also immensely beneficial to regulate blood pressure and blood sugar levels. Black pepper. I hope you all have seen this. This is called miri. A pinch of black pepper, when added to any recipe, enhances the flavor manifold. Black pepper, also known as the king of spices, promotes weight loss, helps relieve cold and cough, improves digestion, boosts metabolism, and treats many skin problems. In fact, a glass of haldi doodh becomes much more therapeutic with a pinch of black pepper. As you can see, this is ginger, ala. It has been used to help digestion, reduce nausea, and help fight the flu and common cold. Ginger is an important ingredient in the traditional kadha recipe too. Now, apart from all these mentioned in your pre-reading activity, there are so many other medicinal herbs, creepers, plants which you see in our daily life, in our day-to-day activities. Let's say, for example, tulsi, correct? It is a medicinal plant. Although we consider it holy and worship it, it is a medicinal plant. Then you have aloe vera, which is good for skin, correct? What else? Can you recollect some other elements which you have seen in your daily life, in your neighborhood, where if you have plants, if you have a garden of your own, have you planted any small shrubs, herbs, creepers, which are of medicinal value? Can you think of them, recollect them, or if you have them planted in your garden, can you make a list of some more elements? Right. I will wait for your answers. You can write them down in your notebooks. You can make a separate notebook for English. And if you feel some points are important, you can note them down in the notebook so that all the material of English class will remain in the same notebook for you to refer quickly and easily. So if you find any other element which relates to this topic of ours, you can make a note of it in the notebook and keep. So this is how many creepers, many shrubs, many plants are of medicinal value. But sometimes we least realize them. Now, dear students, here, this is a lesson, unit number 3, and the title is Around a Medicinal Creeper. Now, what is this exactly? Let's read in brief. This is the story of an unusual medicinal creeper. As you can see in the picture, if you have a text, you will get the same picture in your textbook also. There's a huge tree to which a creeper has been tied. or the creeper has grown, taking the support of that tree. You can see, if you observe clearly, you will see the tree as well as the creeper. And you also can see some people standing near the tree and are talking among themselves. Now, what they are talking, who are they? We will read further in the lesson. So, this is the story of an unusual medicinal creeper, firstly. Then, there were many stories about this creeper. As we go through the lesson, start reading the lesson, you will understand that the medicinal creeper which you are seeing here had many stories to be told about. But some stories were true, some stories were imaginary, and some were totally false. Okay. To learn some facts about this plant, this medicinal creeper, it took the narrator almost 20 years. Oh my God. So 20 years span was required for the author to know in detail about this medicinal creeper. So my dear students, this lesson is all about one such medicinal creeper. Then how people did not realize its value, but later the author discovered it, and how different people spin different stories about it. So, we shall continue the same lesson in the next week. Till then, you all take care, be at home, be safe, take care of yourself. Bye.